The February 2022 release of the SAP Cloud Application Programming Model, CAP, is out now for us to get our teeth into. Here are a few highlights. In the docs and samples area, there's a new keyboard shortcut overview for us keyboard warriors, and there's a brand new deploy and operate cookbook. There's a fantastic looking data browser sample, which is both useful and highly educational too. There's support for simple field extensibility, which is experimental and has been released for testing and feedback purposes. There's support for multi-line string literals, and in particular, the triple backtick version does automatic indentation stripping, which is really nice. There's all sorts of other features and new concepts in the February 2022 release. So head over to the CAPI documentation and check out all the details.
Join this free course online to learn about the Git-enabled change and transport system and how you can leverage it to set up DevOps for SAP S/4HANA ABAP development processes. This is a six-week course that starts from March 7th, 2022 to April 19th, 2022. The aim of this course is to provide you with an understanding of gCTS in all its aspects. You'll get to know the features and options that are a part of the standard delivery and learn how you can extend gCTS to adapt into your processes and needs. The course also includes exercises for you to practice what you've learned. This course is targeted at administrators, developers, and DevOps engineers who are working in SAP S/4HANA environments and want to learn about gCTS. The course is free. Just register for an account on openSAP and take the course. Click on the link in the description to enroll today.
If you want to enable your users to create augmented reality experiences on their own without the need to write code, the wait is over. The FioriAR Swift package allows you to provide a whole workflow for creating and editing AR scenes. And on top of that, there is an SAP Mobile Services integration as well, which allows you to publish created AR scenes to the cloud. With the mobile augmented reality feature, you can edit AR scenes on the fly and add additional locales to it. The beauty is that these changes can be pulled into your app during runtime without the need for shipping an update. I've created a brand new tutorial and blog post covering all the new functionality to give you an easy start into building amazing AR experience apps and trying out the SAP Mobile Services integration. So what are you waiting for? Head over to developers.sap.com and give it a try. Links directly to the tutorial and blog post are in the description of this video.
We wanted to bring your attention to a three-part blog post series that has been published recently. It's about development containers, VS Code, and tutorials on the tutorial navigator, and in particular, tutorial prerequisites. It demonstrates an approach to help newcomers get started more quickly with tutorials by providing a container with all the tools that are prerequisite for a given tutorial ready to use. Check out the three-part series, grab a coffee, read through, and please, please, please let us know what you think. Provide your thoughts in comments to each or any of the blog posts. Thanks.